Hello everybody, my name is Mary
Somerville. My name is
Noalina. My name is Noalisha.
We are from SMP Slayang Baru.
For STEM.
We are going to present the story of Mary Somerville.
Mary Fairfax, or better known as Mary Somerville, was born on December 26, 1780 in Jedburgh, Scotland. She was a Scottish scientist, writer, and polymath, and her scientific career was science writing and mathematics. She studied mathematics and astronomy and was nominated to be jointly the first female member of the Royal Astronomical Society at the same time as Caroline Herschel. Mary, also known as the Queen of 19th Century Science, Mary Somerville explained the leading scientific ideas of her days in terms that much of the educated public could understand. Thus, she conducted some original research. Somerville's works as a translator and interpreter influenced how development in the physical science were discussed and delineated. She was also responsible for the first geography text ever published in English. Somerville was the daughter of Sir William George and Margaret. Her mother was Scottish, while her father was English. He served as a vice admiral in the Royal Navy and was a hero of the Battle of Campendown. Due to the demands of his works, he was often away from home. Somerville was the fifth of seven children, who grew up in Burntisland, a small Scottish coastal village.
Instead, she ran wild exploring the Scottish coast while avoiding dolls and other feminine thoughts. Somerville did not learn to read very well, could not write at all, and knew nothing of number or language. At the time, daughters were expected to focus on domestic and social matters. They were also expected to master at least minimal reading and writing skills to put their daughter on the right path and curb her wild behavior. Somerville's parents sent her at the age of 10 to an elite girls' boarding school located in Musselbach. She learned very little. Somerville did not like the stifling educational methods, which focused on repetition and memorizing. So she began to enjoy reading and learn some handwriting, grammar, arithmetic, and French. Somerville remained at this school for only 12 months. Somerville grew into a socially active teenager who was known for her beauty. She was properly instructed in domestic and social arts. Her life changed profoundly at the age of 15. When she encountered algebraic symbol while reading a fashion magazine, Somerville became intrigued and wanted to learn more. She studied algebra on her own and craved more knowledge. Though she began to receive some private instruction, Somerville's parents tried to discourage these pursuits. Her father feared that she might drive herself insane. At the time, it was believed that a woman's constitution could not handle much intellectual effort without causing damage on her physical and mental health.
Despite the efforts of her parents to stop her, which included confiscating candles to prevent her from studying at night, Somerville continued to learn. She read her father's books on navigation. She taught herself Latin so she could read Euclid and learn about his geometry. Somerville read and committed to memory six of his books as well as other classics. She managed to dodge the lack of candles at night by memorizing formulas she wanted to work on and solving problems in her head in the dark. Somerville did have some supporters. Her brother's tutor bought her books she needed, as proper women did not go into bookstores. A sympathetic uncle helped her with classical studies. For the most of the part, however, Somerville was dissuaded from pursuing her studies. After the death of her husband and son, Somerville resumed her studies, shortly before returning to Scotland with her surviving son. Somerville to continue her intellectual pursuits, though she maintained her family, domestic and social obligation. Many members of her family as well as friends derided her decision to give up her studies. Somerville did have some encouragement from leading intellectuals and scholars in Edinburgh, including William Wallace, who became professor of mathematics at Edinburgh University. Somerville studied higher mathematics and physical astronomy. She read Isaac Newton's book, Principle, and began to submit solution problems posted in contests run by mathematics journals. In 1811, Somerville won a silver prize for solving a Diophantine equation from a mathematical repository.